Good afternoon, dear students. Myself Parottama, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, GFGC, Gauri Bidanur. Welcome for the session 50. In this session, we are going to solve the problems on break-even point. In the previous class, also we solved the problems on break-even point. The main objective of this chapter is to sensitize the student with the techniques of marginal costing and budgetary control. The session outcome will be able to calculate the break-even point by applying the cost-volume-profit analysis. See the problem. Consider the following data of a company: sales 40,000, fixed cost 7,500, variable cost 17,500. Find the following: contribution, profit, and break-even point. According to the problem, the sales is equal to 40,000, fixed cost 7,500, and variable cost 17,500. First, calculation of contribution. As we know that the formula for calculation of contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost. In the above problem, the volume of sale is 40,000 less variable cost is 17,500. Then we will get 22,500 is the contribution. Then second one, calculation of profit. Profit is equal to contribution less fixed cost. As we know that the value of contribution is equal to 22,500 less fixed cost is 7,500. The profit is equal to 15,000. Third one, break even point. Formula for calculation of break even point is equal to fixed cost into sales divided by sales minus variable cost. In this problem, fixed cost is 7,500 multiplied by sales is 40,000 divided by sales 40,000 minus variable cost is 17,500. Break even point is equal to 13,333 rupees. See the second problem. From the following data, you are required to calculate break even point and net sales volume at this point. Direct material cost per unit 10 rupees, direct labor cost per unit 5 rupees, fixed overhead 50,000 rupees, variable cost at 60% on direct labor, that is 60% of 5 rupees, selling price per unit 25 rupees, trade discount 4% on selling price. If sales are 10% and 25% above the break-even volume, determine the net profit. Solution: selling price per unit is 25 rupees less trade discount 4% on selling price. Calculate 4% on 25 rupees, then we will get 1 rupee. Deduct 1 rupee from 25 rupees, then we will get 24 rupees net selling price per unit. From this, deduct variable cost per unit. direct material 10 rupees, direct labor 5 rupees, variable overhead 60% on direct labor, that is 60% on 5 rupees, then we will get 3 rupees, total 18 rupees. Deduct 18 rupees from 24 rupees, then we will get 6 rupees. So this is the contribution per unit. Then calculation of break even point in units. Formula is equal to break even point is equal to fixed cost divided by selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit. Fixed cost is 50,000 rupees divided by variable selling price per unit 24 minus variable cost per unit 18 rupees. Then we will get 6 rupees. Divide 6 rupees by 50,000 rupees. Then we will get 8,333 units is the break-even point. Break-even point in sales volume. Formula for calculation of this is break-even point is equal to fixed cost into sales divided by PV ratio. First calculate the PV ratio by applying the formula. PV ratio is equal to contribution divided by sales multiplied by 100 is equal to contribution is 24 minus 18 divided by 24 multiplied by 100. Contribution is 6 rupees divided by 24 multiplied by 100. Then we will get 25%. This is the PV ratio. Then calculate break even point by applying the formula. Fixed cost 50,000 divided by PV ratio is 25% is equal to 50,000 divided by 25 multiplied by 100, then we will get 2 lakhs. Calculation of profits when the sales are 10% above the break even volume. First calculate 10% of 2 lakhs, then we will get 20,000. Add 20,000 to 2 lakhs, that is equal to 2,20,000. Apply the formula for calculation of contribution. This contribution is equal to sales multiplied by PV ratio. As we know that the volume of sale is equal to 2,20,000 divided by 25 multiplied by 100, then we will get 55,000. Profit when the sales are 25% above the break-even point. Formula for calculation of this contribution is equal to fixed cost plus desired profit. We know the value of contribution and fixed cost. Then the contribution is equal to 55,000. Fixed cost is 50,000. Deduct 50,000 from 55,000. Then the profit is equal to 5,000. See the next problem. From the following particulars, find out the break-even point. Variable cost per unit 15 rupees. Fixed cost 54,000 rupees. Selling price per unit 20 rupees. What should be the selling price per unit if the break-even point should be brought down to 6,000 units? Solution. Contribution per unit is equal to sales minus variable cost. It is 20 rupees minus 15 rupees is equal to 5 rupees. It is a contribution per unit. Apply the formula for break-even point is equal to fixed expenses divided by contribution per unit. As we know that The break-even point is equal to 6,000, 54,000 fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Contribution per unit is equal to fixed cost divided by break-even point, that is 54,000 divided by 6,000, then we will get 9 rupees. Contribution is 9 rupees. Variable cost is 15 rupees. Then selling price is equal to contribution plus variable cost, that is 24 rupees per unit. Next problem. Calculate the amount of fixed expenses, number of units to be break even, number of units to earn a profit of 40,000. The selling price per unit can be assumed at 100. The company sold in two successive periods 7,000 units and 9,000 units and has incurred a loss of 10,000 and earned 10,000 profit respectively. See the statement. Period 1, period 2 sales 7 lakh, 9 lakh, profit or loss 10,000, 10,000. Thus, for an additional sale of 2 lakhs, there is an additional contribution of 20,000 which has voided off the loss or 10,000 of period 1 and earned a profit of 10,000 in period 2. First one, the amount of fixed expenses. PV ratio is equal to contribution divided by sales multiplied by 100. 20,000 divided by 2 lakhs multiplied by 100 is equal to 10%. Profit of period 2, 10 divided by 100 multiplied by 7 lakhs, then we will get 70,000. Loss of period 1 is equal to 10,000. Fixed cost is 80,000. Calculation of number of units to be break even. Break even point is equal to fixed cost divided by PV ratio is equal to 80,000 divided by 10%. That is 80,000 divided by 10 multiplied by 100 is equal to 8 lakhs. Number of units to break even point. Break even sales divided by selling price per unit. 8 lakhs divided by 100 is equal to 8,000 units. The break even point in units is equal to 8,000. Third one, calculation of number of units to earn a desired profit of 40,000. Formula for this, break even point is equal to fixed cost plus desired profit divided by PV ratio. As we know that fixed cost 80,000 plus desired profit 40,000 divided by 10%. 120,000 divided by 10 multiplied by 100. The break even point in rupees is 12 lakhs. These are the references to this slide. Thank you very much for understanding.